So thanks for joining in today for our educational webinar over finding the right fit, where you'll walk away with a few strategies on winning your next bid and how you can bring the right carrier with accurate rating tools together through a TMS called BrokerPro and our platform called C4. Let's see here. Just a few housekeeping things before we kick off. I would encourage you to share any questions or comments or even experiences you've had regarding today's topic. So please enter those in the chat. And typing in your thoughts. We'll get to those towards the end of the webinar. We'll also be recording this session along with a link to everyone here today. So if you'd like to share it with your team or watch it again, feel free to do so. On that, I'm Chris Arredondo, this guy on the left here, co-founder and VP of pretty much everything customer related here at Cargo Chief. Along with me, I have Joe McAlpin, president of BrokerPro, who you'll hear more about here in the next coming slides. Today, we'll be going over finding the right fit and how finding the best carrier with the right pricing strategies will help you win your next bid. As we go into each topic, we'll also be showing quick intros into both BrokerPro and C4 that you'll hear more about through the webinar. So on that, Joe, why don't you tell us a little bit more about yourself and BrokerPro?
Oh, thanks, Chris. And thanks for allowing me to be a part of your informative webinar. Infinity Software has been around for over 20 years, and it focuses on providing forward-thinking transportation software to assist our customers in managing their day-to-day operations. Our goal is to deliver a TMS that is intuitive and affordable, as well as extremely robust. In fact, Broker Plus offers more than 20 integration tools so that users don't have to leave their TMS in order to accomplish the task.
Nice. Yeah, I know having a monthly subscription model like you guys have there, it definitely helps make things more affordable as a company grows. So a little bit more about what we do here at Cargo Chief is provide practical, unique, and current data to help logistics teams like yourselves make those better business decisions. The two main problems we really solve for are capacity and rating. Related to our integration with BrokerPro, with rating, we focus on providing information that you can understand quickly to help take the guesswork out of quoting and buying, and so you don't have to have an economics degree to make your next bid. We see that with some of the pricing tools out there. A lot of it's delayed and you're still having to make that educated guess. So we step in to help reduce that risk of guessing so you don't end upside down on a load and of course can start covering freight at a profit. So really the foundation, of how confident you are in rates, pricing better and finding the right fit comes down to carrier development. A few ways you can do this is starting with a carrier profile. You really want to have one place that you can store information and to quickly queue it up when you need it. There are a few methods I hear that this is done, whether it's on a sticky note, in Excel, in a share drive or a notebook. It's still a very important part of that procurement process. I think Joe will actually get into what pulling up historical carriers looks like in BrokerPro here shortly and how easy it can be. To add on to building a carrier profile, you should also spend every call procuring. I think when a carrier calls in on posted loads, don't just hang up because they weren't empty in time, but maybe jot down who they are, what they like to run, how often they run lanes, and add all of that information into a carrier profile so you can store it and you're not having to chase it down wherever it is. On top of that, when you are pitching out spot freight or loads in general to carriers, you always want to be transparent on load requirements, like things like tarp sizes and weights especially, so there aren't any surprises. And so you have more holistic quote when you're working with your shippers. Some good things to talk about are commodities, types of freights, and even corridors. So you're also learning from carriers and using that information when you're pricing out new freight and gaining knowledge to price more confidently on your next bid. Another strategy and how this ties into finding the right fit is to use regular carriers to pre-book with. These carriers are already complied, ready to go and set up. So there's literally no onboarding time spent. The more you pre-book with them, the more they'll be in favor for your next quotes. Even if you're just fishing around a lane, or just trying to get a sense on the market instead of ghost posting and having to field all those inbound calls. On the other hand, when you are having to find a new carrier, the compliance and onboarding process is a necessary step in getting a solid carrier on your freight. I know Broker Pro, I think what Joe mentioned earlier, they do have a handful of integrations that help streamline that time spent there that Joe will actually be showing you here in a moment. Using those relationships that you've built with through inbound calls or outsourcing, whatever it is, to drive your conversational quoting or buying, also gives your customer, your shipper, a lot more confidence too. And you'll have a much better experience working together, even if it's just for that first time. So using a few of these strategies will help you find the right carrier partner. A good method and rank order for doing so should be going to your regular carriers, your historical capacity, then outside tools to add to your carrier base. So Joe, what have you heard from other companies regarding capacity, and what solutions are they looking for?
Well, I think capacity and driver shortage has been the hot topic for the last several years, and it will probably continue to be. For those who don't have dedicated carriers for those repetitive lanes and hard to cover freight, you know, obviously you see the load boards playing a big role, but also the rating engines and pricing tools to help assist them with the spot market.
Yeah. And I think, you know, when we think about how to follow that order of regular carriers, then historical capacity mostly comes down to your TMS. I know with my times at a brokerage, we mostly use tribal knowledge to recall that capacity, yelling across the room, hey, who was that guy I just called in, or where's Enrique, or whoever it is, mostly because it took way too long in the TMS that we were using. And to that point also, finding that data can be hard if your TMS doesn't have capacity-oriented solutions and you're still left buying that third monitor to have additional tools open. So Joe, I think I'm going to pass this over to you now so we can get a sneak peek into Broker Pro. Okay. But can you also show us how someone using your TMS can find that historical capacity, act on it, and keep everything in one place? Should be able to share. Let me know if you can't, if I'm being stingy.
Well.
Let's see here. Let me hop to... give it a try now. Let me know what that does for you.
Okay, yeah. It says it's been disabled.
Oh, let's try it now.
Still says disabled. Host disabled participant share screen.
Oh, no. Let me see here. I'm going to pass you host rights. That might work. Let's try that out. I love Zoom. They update things all the time and never give me a heads up.
Oh, yeah. I understand. Yeah. You got it now?
All righty. Yeah, I see.
Okay. So, yeah. So, as in Broker Pro, the users have the ability to create these groups of carriers, what we call preferred carriers. Give them a name, flatbed carriers, West Coast carriers, refrigerated carriers, and then they can send out bid requests. You said we got an alert that popped up. Broker Pro is full of alerts, reminders, and notifications. We'll snooze that. But got several of them. They can create those, and then they can send bid requests out to the carrier, asking them how much they would charge to haul that load. Also, they can send out a bulk bid request of all their loads to their carriers, asking them to respond back and things like that. When it comes to historical history, what I've done here, I've gone to our advanced load search and pulled up all loads that shipped in 2020 that went from Alabama to Florida, Georgia, Louisiana, Mississippi, Texas. So Southeast. And so it gave me three pages worth, probably a couple hundred, 132 loads. And then the user can kind of come in and sort those, do different. He can also do different views of the columns of what they want to see. They can export all the search results and all the reports out to PDF and Excel. But what I mean by searching, so if you want to go here now and see all the B Trucking's loads that they did. Okay. Or a Doug Andrus. Or he wanted to look at a specific customer, 3GIS, and see the loads and the carriers of all those loads. They're able to kind of filter and search and sort, as well as memorize a report and have it scheduled to come into their inbox on a regular basis. Now, you mentioned earlier about compliance and onboarding carriers. We have interface with DAT, Safer, DAT Carrier Watch, Safer Watch, and RMIS, where a user can go in while they're on the phone with the carrier, give them a quick lookup. Let's see if I remember to log in. Yeah. Pulls up that carrier's profile on SaferWatch. They can review that carrier. If they like them and want to use them, go ahead and import them. We also onboarding through my carrier packets, data onboard, and RMIS to shoot prospective carriers an email and let them log into your account, upload information, upload their packet, and then back in Broker Pro, you'll receive a notification that carrier's been onboarded. So again, we try to keep it streamlined and simple to get that information in the system as fast as possible.
Yeah, I noticed it was really fast because I think, you know, like I was saying, the TMS that I've used personally in a brokerage setting, that, you know, queuing those carriers up, it's really hard to do just because the time it takes and just the multiple clicks. It looks like you were able to kind of go back to your list there. If I wanted to see like all outbound carriers from Alabama, if I have a, I don't know, maybe I'm got a new shipper and I'm trying to find carriers that run Alabama outbound to like Southeast, I think is what you said. So like in that list, I can, I guess, export it and just like, and include carrier phone numbers and things like that, or.
Yeah. Yeah. You saw right here with this listing, I can tell it what I want to see, what columns.
Yeah.
And then you see over here, the different columns. And when you get ready to export, you know, you can tell, do you want to send the whole table or do you just want to send the columns being displayed?
Wow. So, yeah, okay. That's good. I know, you know, we here at Cargo Chief, we get a lot of requests to like export a big list. And I think, you know, that's what a lot of brokerages are used to work through Excel and just like sort them and organize them somehow and then just call through as you're procuring those new carriers. And I like the speed there. It's super quick. So I think that's it for this portion. I think, Joe, if you want to pass it back to me, I don't know how we're going to handle this, but so let's figure this out here. I think I...
Where is the...
So if you hover over my name and click more, you should be able to make me a host.
I believe it's, I see it.
That's going to give me rights. You're being a little stingy with the...
I know it. I'm going to hold the mouse on the keyboard here. Try that now. You should be.
Yeah, let's see here. Think so. Joe, can you see my screen?
Yes.
Awesome. All right. So getting back into the slides here, we talked about, it actually saw how those historical and regular carriers have an impact and how quick it is and how easy it is to find that information in a TMS like Broker Pro. The pricing aspect sometimes starts with a similar strategy to finding carriers where you're in a TMS or some other tools like RSC4. While you're looking at that historical capacity, you can quickly see what rates a carrier ran that lane for last. When we think about going outside of that and into lanes that we don't have history on, where we're having to use other tools or just Ghost Post or whatever it is, an accurate rating tool is hands down one of the most important things you need in parallel with that capacity source. As I mentioned earlier, a lot of the tools out there are delayed by that 7 to 14 days, and that's even after delivery. So when you think about it, how are you supposed to win freight or make a profit with weeks old rates? So to that, one of our solutions that I'll be showing here shortly is just that, an accurate rating tool, where the difference is that it focuses on the pickup date as transactions come in and are booked, with information coming from TMSs, factoring companies, and C4 users. We'll often have pre-booked transactions and data on those high density lanes, so you don't have to guess what the price will be. Having an accurate rating tool goes beyond just seeing a number and booking and going. I think when you think about an RFP that you might have coming up, it's important that accuracy is also applied to historical numbers. Often on those RFPs, there are lanes that you've never ran before that you might not have a well-rounded quote on. Maybe you guys haven't just ran the lane, haven't procured a carrier, have no sense of density there, or freight mix or anything. So here, if we're taking a lane like California to Texas, I think specifically this was Ontario to Houston, so the LA area. If I have an RFP coming up, it's a good practice to see what kind of volatility a lane like this has. Some characteristics of this lane. One is that it's a longer haul, and it's impacted by ports and seasonality. But as we all know, the hardest thing to forecast on over the last 9 months is the impact that COVID-19 has had on those certain lanes. When we look at a yearly comparison with 2019, there were common changes, but expected, and even as rates were at an all-time high in 2019. Then in 2020, we had historically low rates as that panic buying happened right there in March, April area, paired with the shelter in place protocols. And then as the stimulus started to happen, that sharp increase came and exceeded all-time highs with changes of more than $1,000. When we look at the graph on the right, with a shorter haul like Dallas to Houston, there was very little impact due to COVID. Using an accurate rating tool to understand that correlation between the volatility and the length of haul will help you make more informed decisions on those upcoming RFPs and lanes that you're unfamiliar with. And I think here too, it's, you know, when you're just blindly quoting in an RFP, relying on that rating tool, it's kind of hard to have confidence in that rate unless that rate is accurate, even when it's applied to those historical data points. So after you've looked at possible volatility and have narrowed in on a strategy to find the right carrier, the next thing to look at is how you're pricing. This is one of the most important parts because after all, you can't grow unless you're winning more freight. And it's important to understand that winning more opportunities isn't biased towards just the sell side when you're quoting or bidding on freight, but also on the buy side when you're negotiating with carriers. When we think about short hauls and easy lanes, when there's less risk, faster transit times, adding that extra $150 to the shipment often leaves you missing out on opportunities. I'm thinking about our Dallas to Houston example, that lane barely even changed by like $100, $150. So adding that extra, just add an extra $150 is a big, big change and impact on that lane if you're trying to win it. The inverse, if you're not considering what's going into your rates, and quoting or pricing with zeros and fives, that's more often than not going to put you out of the market when compared to competitors. So asking yourself, why is pricing on zeros or fives hurting my business? This is typically where larger brokers come into play that have the technology that does these quoting calculations for them, where they're winning the freight or bid by not pricing on fives or zeros, where that's kind of more of a mentality on the manual rep side, but they're doing it with margin that will bring their price to shipper at 568, for example, undercutting all the other bids of 575. At this point, they're passing that margin difference back to the carrier while knowing what their absolute max buy should be. Luckily, I learned a lot of these tactics when I started my career at CH and through XPO. So I was able to grow a former brokerage from 11 to 18% just by pricing with margin while increasing revenue and winning those new opportunities, new bids, just by a simple strategy like pricing with margin. Another reason of why is because you're doing just that, pricing in increments of 50 or 100 bucks and not leaving room to do the opposite when you're finding carriers that meet your cost point. If you're negotiating with a carrier in buckets of 100 bucks, that starts to add up really fast and impact your margin. You should always ask the question, why not try to go with an extra $73 instead of 100 bucks before you go and give the farm away? So some things I've done before to help price better and win more opportunities regarding increments is pitching volume to carriers or spending time to develop relationships to hone in on that price point. In addition, I've always either had an alternative website that cross-calculated for me or calculator to cross-check what my max buy should be. It was always important to have that max buy in mind, even if that carrier told me 575, I needed to know that 568 was the absolute. So here, let's hop into our tool C4, just to give an example of what this would look like as you're working with margins and whether it's a website or calculator or whatnot. So while negotiating, I think, you know, with carriers, 9 times out of 10, that carrier is going to counter and come down. The key is the closer you are to their number, the more likely that carrier will actually take your freight, even in today's market. So let's say I click on this carrier here. I've ran the search kind of pre-populated Atlanta to Lakeland. Let's say I click on this guy here. As I'm calling through, I pitch a rate of 1400 bucks first to set a floor. Here I can see that my rate's at 1600. I kind of want to be a little bit under that. This is trying to tell me that the rate to get a truck is going to be around 1600 bucks. So of course I'm going to come in at 14. The carrier might tell me and say 17 when maybe I only have 1650 in the load. And if I'm bidding back with 50s and 100s, I'm leaving too much on the table, and not trying to go in small increments, which is what I should do. And of course, instead of hanging up, I'd always need to know that margin goal. Because sometimes, like I said earlier, 9 times out of 10, that carrier is going to come down. So here, if my margin goal, let's say it's 10%, I think in this example that I have queued up here, 10%, my max buy would actually be 1461, not 1500. So typically what a lot of reps do and what I've seen in my past is they'll just go from 14 to 15 to 16 and already that's $200 where all that money was left on the table and already eating into my profits. So using a calculator like this, and you can find these online, not just C4. And if any of you need one, a calculator, I can send you a few links that takes you to some of those sites that calculates it for you. But when I'm using that margin, it helps me keep in line with those margin goals. And imagine if you're able to do that on 200 loads a month, that would have brought in an extra $7,800 in margin with that $39 difference here between 1461 and 15. So adding and saving that extra cost savings is, it really adds up when you're booking at volume. Let's see here. So before I tail out of this tool, on an earlier slide, I mentioned the three sources that we use to pull in transactions from TMSs, factoring companies, and C4 users. So on a lane like this, if we actually look at Monday for this lane, so here I've got tomorrow, but if I just want to see what Monday is and kind of the impact of an accurate pricing tool, you'll see this rate change. And how it changes is based on the recent transactions and data that's coming in. And kind of the goal of our rating tool is to give you that transparency, a better picture of what end of the range you should be bidding on, and to help reduce that guesswork that's involved in that rating or buying or whatever it is. So here in a lane like this, we can see a recent transaction that picked up on the 19th. What's today? The 21st is probably a good example here. So picking up on the 19th, 460 miles, probably delivered yesterday, and it moved for $1,400. So you can kind of have an idea of when you're looking at this range over here, what should I actually be paying? You know, if your customer says, hey, can you do 16 or 15? You know that you can cover it for 14 since it just moved for that. So you have a really clear picture on what that market is doing. Whereas if it was, that was for Monday, but if I'm looking at tomorrow, for Friday, we know that carrier is probably going to have to hold over that load. You can see the difference in rate there already just by knowing, by Lane Master bringing in that recent data to give you that better rate. So let me get back into the slides here. See if I can figure this part out. So getting back into the slides, I think we can all agree that the carrier is going to hold that secret rate at the end of the day. Doesn't really matter what rate you have in front of you, but it's important that you're using your pricing tools to guide you to the rate that will actually get you a truck. So with both a rating tool and a TMS like Broker Pro, having a single source that's accurate and intuitive will help give you that ROI that you're trying to look for and strive for. So Joe, with a pricing tool like Lane Master, NC4, what does that look like in Broker Pro? And can you take us through the life cycle of a quote, maybe from creation of a quote to accessing pricing?
Sure. I appreciate that. I'd be glad to.
Sure. I think I clicked the wrong button for you there, Joe. One second here. Hang on. It's like you're remote controlling my monitor over here. Let's see here. You took over my mouse.
Go ahead.
Let's see here. Should be able to pass you to host again. There we go. That should do it.
Yeah, here we go. So this is our dashboard. So when a user first logs in, it takes them to a dashboard, and as database grows, information starts feeding back to him. Down at the bottom here is our quotes to load triangle. And every year it refreshes. So for 2021, I've created 8 quotes worth 61,000. 3 are still active worth 17,000. And I've converted 5 worth almost 44,000. So they kind of get a quick overview year to date, company wide, how we're doing on our quote conversion. If I go to a quote, this is load quote 50565 for ABC Packing. And so it's for one load picking up in Willowbrook, Illinois, going to Houston, Texas. And so he's able to come in, build the quote, post his load board accounts, post everywhere, truck stop, DAT, whichever ones he has. I also send out bid requests to his carriers, asking them how much would you charge, you know, reply back with a quote. Submit the quote to the customer when he gets a rate for it. In fact, let me go back before I do that. Down here at the bottom, you'll see the line haul rates for Lane Master that's been fed back into the software, the fuel cost plus the line haul, or the flat rate, including both. But you mentioned margins a minute ago. So in Broker Pro, the user is able to go in and put that margin he wants, in this case, 10%. And so it's showing, hey, at 90% of this is 21.77, 110% of this is 26.61. So kind of helps him know what to buy or sell at, or what he can negotiate with. Now up here in the customer, we'll put a flat rate of $2,800. And they can do accessorials, like here's a lumper fee, and they can have as many of those as they need, just depending on, you know, what's going on, as well as a fuel surcharge, flat rate, percentage per mile. So then when they get ready to submit it to the customer, here's what it would look like: their logo, company information, their customer, any notes they want to include, breakdown of the load, the rate, and a place for the customer to sign off on. So they submit that to the customer, and hopefully that customer is going to respond back and say, you got it, go pick it up, Chris, and they can convert it to a load.
Nice. So that Lane Master rate down there, which is C4's pricing tool, that, so a user doesn't have to like go and do a search by origin, destination, trailer type. It'll just queue up whenever they.
Yeah. As soon as it, if I was to hit save and continue, it'll probably say fetching rate. That's already got it. So it's kind of in the queue there since we've already got it. But yeah, it just displays it. As soon as they put in the pickup and delivery information, hit save, it goes and fetches that information.
Yeah. So that makes it a lot easier to kind of convert that quote to load. And also that margin, I know, you know, earlier I mentioned like the large brokers typically are the ones that have that technology, but that's good to have that, you know, right there in a TMS that's affordable and not $20,000 right up front. So that's good to have. Yeah, definitely. Joe, I guess, do you want to go ahead and pass it down to me? I think we got a few more minutes here.
Yeah.
I think you might have to make me the host again.
I'm working on it. I'm slower. I'm used to GoToMeeting, so I've got to. How's that?
I think that worked here. Let's see. All right. Yeah. So just to wrap up here, we kind of have a few questions. I'm not too sure if we'll be able to get to any here that might have been asked, but if there are, just feel free to put them in, and we'll follow up here after the webinar. But one of the biggest things, one of the larger questions that I've been asked, I guess, is what makes C4's pricing tool better or more accurate than the other tools that are out there? So, you know, hearing customers and getting their feedback, one of the biggest things that I've seen is to be accurate when they need it. Lane Master will give you the transparency you need to be confident in the rates you're bidding with, mostly focusing on that pickup date, like I showed earlier, not delivery. And also showing insight into the actual transactions as they're being booked is really beneficial. Whether you're trying to show that to a customer like, hey, carriers really are charging me $5 a mile, even though it's not your transaction, you still have insight outside of your own network. Another important thing is that we just don't give you a range that you might have saw earlier, $3,000 to $4,600, and say, good luck, go win freight. But we try to hone in more on that range, more narrowed, to provide a rate that you can be confident in. And I think, you know, as we saw in that example earlier, you can actually select those dates in the future to forecast what that rate will actually be on Monday instead of guessing. And of course, that depends on how much data and transactions are coming in on that particular lane. And Joe, can you tell how easy it is, I guess, to integrate C4's pricing tool, Lane Master, with Broker Pro?
Yeah, it's really just a matter of the broker having an active account with Lane Master. And then inside Broker Pro, click the connect, and it takes them to their Lane Master account. They log in, and then it reverts back to Broker Pro, and they're automatically connected. So now each time they build a load or a quote, that lane rate is displayed in Broker Pro, like you see here.
Yeah. So it
literally just takes seconds.
Yeah. Right. That's awesome. That's awesome. So I guess that's pretty much the end here. Thanks everyone for joining in today and hearing more about how you can find the right fit to win your next bid. For more information on Broker Pro or Cargo Chief, feel free to reach out to either myself, Chris, or Joe for either a demo or information, and also connect on LinkedIn for more webinars and updates.